So I'm talking about linear USA, not me. At the onset, I would like to thank all the fraternity of GI for inviting me to speak on this topic. But at the very beginning, I would say that radial US is now an obsolete modality most of the time, because you do not have enough time to learn both radial and EUS and linear. So we learn this by books. You can learn books, cadaveric dissection, books of EUS, educational DBT, Boxelman, as we see here, video journal and encyclopedia, then Botton and Cook Medical, articles, how I do it, previous workshop, individual PowerPoints of different doctors who can help and share them, many articles, video commentaries, Symbionics model, and of course, WhatsApp group. There are important videos on US AGSG videos. These are three important videos. And I wrote a book long back. But I would like to say that before starting US, it is important to know the anatomy books. And these are the important anatomy books and atlas which you should be having, because it is within these books you will find that what are the relations, what is anterior, what is posterior, what is right and left. For example, a simple relation of left adrenal gland. These are the four relationships of the two limbs of adrenal gland. And in no book except for the Gray's Anatomy, you will find it simplified in such a simple manner. And in Gray's Anatomy and in many books, you will find what the anterior relationship, posterior relationship, right relationship, and left relationship. For example, this is the adrenal gland that you see. And adrenal gland, you have to find out what is the right adrenal gland, what is the left adrenal gland relationship. Again, the adrenal gland, as we see, again, in relation to inferior vena cava. So the mind must know what are the relationship we have to be anterior, posterior, and that goes because you must start imagining yourself that you are sitting in the stomach or in the esophagus, and you are looking either to the left or posteriorly or to the right or whichever side. And you're rotating your scope to the left or right. And here is why I would say theme sectional, cross-sectional anatomy becomes an important book which you should be having. And though this diagram is too elaborate, but yes, you can imagine when you're in the stomach, you will be able to see this ligament, liver, left lobe of liver. You see in this direction, the beam goes there, you see IVC, aorta. Important thing is when you see IVC, you cannot see spleen from the stomach. What you can see is important. What you cannot see is equally important. And you must remember that these are the three planes, sagittal, frontal, coronal, and all these planes, axial plane. The two planes, axial planes, of course, are the important plane. But this plane is the least important plane because this plane is not important. This plane is important because you know each side, this, these planes are important for you. For example, you see this diagram. Again, from the book, this is the superior mediastinum. You see trachea, esophagus, aorta, and you start thinking what lies anterior, what lies posterior, and you see esophagus and different part of esophagus. You see the relationship of azygos vein, and you start first thinking from inside esophagus, imagining from inside esophagus, and then you know they are not me. Okay, this is what I am. At 22 centimeter distance, 25 centimeter distance, 28 centimeter distance, and what landmark I am going to find at which level and what I am going to see. And these are the important landmarks as I have shown at around 25 centimeter distance. A lot of things are there. There is lower border of azygos vein, lower end of trachea and pulmonary artery. But these landmarks will become familiar and important to you once the mind knows that these are the structure. And then you start imagining what lies anterior to esophagus, what lies posterior to esophagus, what lies to the right and left, mainly the lung, but anterior-posterior relationship, as shown in this figure, are the important landmarks that you start seeing. And then you start seeing, okay, this is the trachea, the right bronchus goes at 25 degree angle, left bronchus goes at 25 degree angle, and you are in posterior mediastinum trying to see the anterior mediastinum. So you start imagining superimposition. Trachea, one by one, esophagus, then trachea comes in front, then the azygos vein going behind the right bronchus, joining superior vena cava, the left brachiocephalic vein coming like this, joining the right brachiocephalic vein and joining the superior vena cava. The arch of aorta going up anterior to the above the arch of left bronchus, going behind the left bronchus, then the pulmonary trunk lies below the arch. So God has made arteries are always higher than the veins. So God has made venous system, left atrial venous system below pulmonary artery, as you can see. So one by one, the four structures I have shown by superimposition of the trachea, and you can imagine those structures one by one. You see the upper esophagus, you see middle esophagus, you see lower esophagus, and then you see the cervical, the thoracic part of esophagus, one by one, by going from one level to another level. When I am coming to books of anatomy, I would say this Frank Grass wrote a book. I am very impressed with the older edition of book. This is Frank Grass, because this is the time when they were struggling to find out how to understand it, and they had original thought. Later on, this book is no longer an important book because it doesn't tell you much as to how you should be doing it. And again, I am impressed by this Chinese book of Quan Chai. Digital anatomy book, I am finding hard. And again, longitudinal sonography by Thomas Roche and Kenneth Chang, important books. Again, one of the less known books is by Laurent Pelagio, who is one of the top endosonographers of France. And his book, you will find something important coming from a surgeon's perspective. And here is, you will find retroportal area, and it's a very interesting book. And some books will have video commentaries. You can find in video commentaries. And of course, we have video journal links, and we have several YouTube links, GI YouTube link, artifact, and there are some articles I have which can we can share on each other with each other as to what are these articles. So we have some educational DVDs, lung cancer on DVD, and EFG working group, one of the earliest important article for education for Japanese group link. And these are two important articles, one on radial US and one on linear US. So do not underthink that radial US is not a good modality. Reading wise, read radial and think linear. You read the article of radial US and read the anatomy, and you think you are holding a linear US, and then you will become even better in your. I published several articles. I was obsessed with the techniques of imaging, and I published on bile duct liver. These are some basics articles of image optimization, endoscopic ultrasound, portal vein, aorta, portal venous system. Then important thing was our assessment of peritoneal spaces, subperitoneal spaces, which are the ligaments, and retroperitoneal spaces is, I'm yet to write about it. The chest and mediastinum, we had a lot of articles of neck, pleura, pleural effusion, endobronchial and endoscopic ultrasound, and of course on the pancreas. Several articles on how to do miscellany. Again, coming back, anatomy, simple thing, how subcarinal space, dissect subcarinal space, because this is the trachea, and the star you see on the trachea, this is the star, is this is the lower end of trachea, this is the lower end of the left bronchus, and then this is the lower end of right main bronchus, and this is the lower end of right middle intermediate bronchus, and then you can see a Jagos vein, and this is the subcarinal area formed by an oblique line joining this lower end. So this is a subcarinal area, and then you start understanding how the outer pulmonary window is formed below the arch of aorta and above the left pulmonary artery. So we have got some idea of applied anatomy of mediastinum, some idea on applied anatomy of biliary tract. This is the mesenteric vein formation, dividing into portal vein two branches, and the right and left hepatic duct joined in front of the right branch of portal vein, common hepatic duct, common cystic duct. So these are the three parts we see, upper, middle and lower part of the common. So the supraduodenal, retroduodenal and infraduodenal part of the bile duct. I would say that imaging of the hepatoduodenal ligament is one of the most important articles I was part of. And this hepatoduodenal ligament is the most important thing we should be imagining, because in this part we will see what are the main structures coming. Portal vein is the post-posterior structure. In front of it on the left side lies the common hepatic artery, dividing into left hepatic artery proper and gastroduodenal artery. And on the right side lies the common hepatic duct, which goes up. So each union and bifurcation going from below upward, you must imagine, and then you must see how this vein, artery, common hepatic duct, common bile duct are uniting and dividing. And this is a diagram where we see one by one. This is the hepatic artery dividing above and below portal vein. And the next diagram shows how the common bile duct goes from the most anterior structure in the hepatic ileum to lie as the most posterior structure when it joins in the ampulla. Slide anatomy of pancreas briefly before I go on to show dorsal and ventral pancreas. And the pancreas dorsal divided into head, body, and tail, though there are no distinct borders between these three. And then this is the body and this is the head, which can be divided into two parts. So head is divided into an anterior part and posterior part. And this is the border between body and tail, which is roughly midway between the whole part of the body. The border is not definite and the midpoint is rough point where you divide body into tail. And the junction of head with body is identified at the left border of portal vein and superior mesenteric vein. And this is the junction. So we need to know these structures basically before we decide in which part, which stuff we are imaging. And this is a diagram which shows different parts of the pancreatic duct, ventral, dorsal, duct of center, and main pancreatic duct. And that is why we should be imaging. So we do, how do we do? We do go one by one. We go from crux, we go to aorta, we go to body of pancreas, and then below the body of pancreas, we are imaging at each vertebral level. I'm going from one level to second level to three. And this is ciliate takeoff and body, and then in front of body, splenic vein, and then a little below the renal artery and renal vein level. When it comes to rotation in the duodenal bulb, we do clockwise and anticlockwise rotation same way. But in one side, you will see the pancreas, and on the other side, you will see the gallbladder. When we are doing rotation in the duodenum, this first rotate in the duodenum, clockwise, pull back, again rotation, pull back, and again rotate. And what you do is keep on gradually coming up all the time to see. Some signs are important. I would like to briefly say that this is a seagull characteristically described for adrenal gland, but the seagull is also formed by the union of veins. And wherever there are two structures uniting, I would call it a seagull-shaped appearance by the union of superior mesenteric vein, splenic vein, to form a portal venous confluence. In this case, though this is again a vascular seagull, this time this is an arterial seagull showing celiac artery dividing into hepatic artery and splenic artery. These are the vascular seagulls which give you a sign, the common hepatic artery dividing into gastroduodenal artery and hepatic artery proper from the duodenal bulb. And again, the venous seagull of portal venous confluence formed by the union of superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein in the duodenum. So the rotation in the pancreas is done again, as I said, in a neutral position. You go down, you start rotating, you pull back, you keep on rotating, and then this is the way you see the structures. And what is important when you come into the duodenal bulb, you rotate one way, you find the gastroduodenal artery, you rotate the other way, you find the hepatic artery proper. One way, you find the lower CBD, other way, you find the upper CBD. So these are some of the figures. This is characteristic neck between the portal vein and the gastroduodenal artery. And this is the way that you define the structure pancreas when you imagine from the common part, from the duodenal bulb. What I said, we mentioned the name of Palazzo. This is the retroportal area, and this is mentioned mainly by Palazzo, though many people now know as surgeons define it, because if there's a lymph node here in gallbladder cancer or in pancreatic cancer, this is a bad sign because the lymph node is far away and inoperable. For example, I will in this case video a few videos show how you do imaging. The gallbladder lies when you see from stomach at 6 o'clock position. And when you see it from the duodenal bulb, you will find the gallbladder roughly at 3 o'clock position. And when you see the gallbladder from the descending duodenum by rotating anticlockwise and moving all the knob up, you will find it at 9 o'clock position.